Welcome to another video. This will be the first video in a series about the sagas from the Viking Age. So grab a drink and let's travel 1000 years back in time to when the Vikings sat around the fire, listening to stories about the gods and goddesses. The first saga is about the goddess Idunn and her apples of youth. There is a man named Aegir, who is greatly skilled in the arts of magic. He lives on the island called Læsø in Kattegat. One day, Aegir traveled to Asgard, the home of the gods. The Æsir knew that Aegir was coming and they welcomed him into their home. But most of what the Æsir showed him was through spells and shapeshifting. In the evening, when it was time to drink, Odin had swords brought to him, into the hall where they were sitting. These swords shone so brightly that no other light was needed while they sat at the table drinking. After the Æsir had been drinking for a while, they went to their feast. The 12 Æsir, who were sitting to be the judges, sat in the high seats. There were Thor, Injor, Frey, Tyr, Heimdall, Bragi, Vidar, Vali, Ul, Hönir, Forseti, and Loki. The goddesses who were to be the judges were Frigg, Freya, Gifjun, Idunn, Gerd, Sigun, Fylla, and Nanna. To Aegir it seemed that everything he saw around him was noble. Spectacular shields hung on the walls around the great hall. Strong and tasty meat was served, and everyone was drinking heavily. Next to Aegir sat Bragi. They drank together and exchanged stories. Bragi told Aegir about the many things that had happened to the Æsir. Bragi began his storytelling by saying that the three of the Æsir, Odin, Loki, and Hönir, were once traveling from Asgard and crossed mountains, wilderness, and even deserts, and the food was difficult to find. Then they arrived at a hill overlooking a valley, and they went down the hill into the valley. Here they saw a herd of oxen, and they decided to take one of them and began to cook it. When they thought that the meat was ready, they opened the cooking pit, but saw that the ox was not cooked. They tried to cook the ox for a second time, and when they opened the cooking pit, the meat was still raw. Now they stood around the cooking pit and asked each other what could the cause of this be. Suddenly they heard a voice coming from above the oak tree, which they were standing under. They looked up and saw an eagle sitting on one of the branches. "I am the one causing the food to remain uncooked. If you are willing to let me eat first, I will let you cook it." The Æsir was hungry and tired, so they agreed to this. The eagle flew down from the tree and landed on the cooking pit. The first thing that the eagle did was to eat the ox's tights and both of its shoulders. This made Loki angry, and he picked up a large stick and started swinging it at the eagle with all his might. Loki struck the eagle, and the eagle started to fly away, but the stick was still stuck in the feathers of the eagle's body, with Loki hanging and dangling on the other end. The eagle flew so close to the ground that Loki's feet were being hit by rocks, dirt, and trees. Loki thought that his arms might be ripped off, and Loki started yelling and begging the eagle for mercy. But the eagle just said that he could not be saved unless he swore an oath that he would find a way to bring Idunn with her apples of youth out of Asgard. Loki agreed to the demands of the eagle, and he was set free and returned to his travel companions. When the Æsir came back to Asgard, Loki made a plan to trick Idunn into leaving Asgard. Loki told Idunn that he had found an apple tree in the forest which had some amazing apples. Loki asked Idunn to bring some of the apples of youth to compare them with these amazing apples he had found. As soon as Loki and Idunn was a few steps from Asgard, the giant Thiasi arrived in the shape of an eagle and grabbed Idunn with his big claws and flew away with her to his home in Trondheim. Weeks and months went by, and Idunn's disappearance started to affect the Æsir in a bad way, and they began to grow old and gray. The Æsir held a meeting together and asked one another about Idunn and what might have happened to her. After many hours of talking, they came to realize that she had last been seen leaving Asgard with Loki. Loki was then dragged to the meeting, where he was threatened with torture or death. After a while, Loki started to become afraid, and he said he would go to the land of the giants to find Idunn, but only if Freya would lend him her falcon shape. When Loki got the falcon shape from Freya, he flew north into Jotunheim, which is the land of the giants. Loki arrived at Thiasi's home in Trondheim on a day the giant was out fishing at sea, so Idunn was all alone in the house. Loki quickly changed Idunn into the shape of a nut, and holding her in his claws, Loki flew away as fast as he could. Later in the day, when Thiasi came home, he found Idunn missing, and he quickly shapeshifted into his eagle shape and flew after Loki. Thiasi bashed his wings in a rage and fury and flew faster than the speed of sound and was just behind Loki when he was near the gates of Asgard. When the Æsir saw the falcon flying with the nut and the eagle in pursuit, they quickly went outside the walls of Asgard carrying piles of wood shavings. As the falcon flew in over the walls of Asgard, it dived down along the walls, and just at that moment, the Æsir set fire to the wood shavings. Thiasi was unable to catch Loki in time, and because he flew so quickly, he was unable to stop himself, flying right into the fire. His feather caught fire, and he fell from the air like a rock, and died as soon as he hit the ground. When Skadi, the daughter of the giant Thiasi, heard the news of her father's death, she put on her helmet and armor and took all her weapons with her. Skadi arrived at the gates of Asgard and was ready to avenge her father. But the Æsir went to the gate and offered Skadi compensation for her father's death. She could choose a husband for herself among the Æsir, but she was only allowed to choose by seeing their feet. When Skadi was standing and looking at the feet of the Æsir, she saw the feet of one man looking very beautiful and said, "I choose that one." Few things on Balder will be ugly, she thought. But to her surprise, it was Enyor from Noatun. Another condition of her settlement was that the Æsir must do something to make her laugh. Loki tied a cord around the beard of a goat and the other around his testicles. Loki and the goat then started pulling back and forth while they were both screaming in pain, until Loki finally fell into Skadi's lap, and then she laughed. With this, the Æsir concluded that they have done their part of the settlement. Odin did one final thing to please Skadi. He took the eyes of Thiasi and threw them up into the sky so they turned into stars. The Æsir started to talk about Thiasi. He seemed to have been exceptionally powerful. Does anyone know of his origin? Bragi answered that Ovaldi was the name of Tiasi's father. You would find it to be an amazing story. Ovaldi had a huge amount of gold, and when he died, his sons, Tiasi, Idi, and Gang, were to divide this inheritance. They divided this gold among them in a strange way. They did it by each taking a turn, taking a bite of the gold. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. And don't forget to check out the playlist with Norse Mythology. There's, I think, over 30 videos in there. See you next Sunday for another story. Thank you for watching.